Hi guys, Rafael Marcolino here, and welcome to Drummo Sapiens every week with a new drum lesson for you. Don't forget to subscribe to the YouTube channel, to follow on Instagram, to like the Facebook page, and if you want to receive every week a new drum lesson directly to your email with transcriptions of every exercise, subscribe to the mailing list at subscribe.drummosapiens.com. In this lesson, I'm going to show you a very good hand exercise that I use a lot. I use it daily to warm up before practice sessions, before rehearsals, before gigs, before recording sessions. I use this exercise a lot, and I've been using this exercise for years. It's a great exercise to develop hand speed and to warm up not just our hands mechanically, but to warm up our brain before playing. One of the most important things that we have to do as a drummer is to keep time. So this exercise is very good to develop your inner clock, to develop your time feel. And I'm going to show you three different levels of this exercise. One is very basic, one intermediate, and one more advanced. So we're going to play different subdivisions, and we're going to play a whole bar of each subdivision. And the first example, the basic version of this exercise, is going to be three bars. One bar of quarter notes, one bar of eighth notes, and one bar of 16th notes. And I know this is very simple, but there are many things that we are working on while playing this exercise that I'm going to explain better after this first example. So I'm going to play this first example on 80 BPM. And we will play always with single strokes, always alternating our hands. One, two, three, four. 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 One. And I know this first example is really, really simple, but I think it's a great workout for the hands because we are playing three different speeds with our hands. We are always playing double the speed of the previous bar. And that's also really good to warm up our brains, to be a good timekeeper. But now I'm going to make it a little bit more complex. For the second version of this exercise, I'm going to add two bars, two different subdivisions. So our sequence is going to be quarter notes, eighth note triplets, 16th notes, and 16th note triplets. And because we have 16th note triplets now, it gets a lot faster. So we are growing the difference between the fastest subdivision and the slowest subdivision of the exercise. So it makes it a little bit more challenging. I'm going to still play it at 8 BPM for you to listen. But if you cannot play 16th note triplets at 8 BPM, you definitely should play the exercise slower. Because the goal here is not to struggle to play anything. It's a warm-up exercise, so you should be able to play it relaxed. So now I'm going to play the second example at 80 BPM. One, two, three, four. 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 One. And there's another way that I like to play this exercise as well. Instead of just going to the last bar and starting over on the first bar, I like to go back and forth with it. So I'm going to show you the same version of this exercise, the second example, but now I'm going to play it back and forth. So when we reach the 16th note triplets, I'm going to go back to 16th notes, then go back to 8th note triplets, and then keep going that way. So that creates different subdivision changes, and that's very good to practice too. Check it out. One, two, three, four. 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 And there it goes. You can keep going back and forth with it. And that's a very good way to practice this as well. And for the final version of this exercise, the third example, we're gonna add every subdivision that exists between 1 and 8 notes for each beat. So we're gonna play quarter notes, eighth note triplets, 16th notes, quintuplets, 16th note triplets, septuplets, and 32nd notes. 8 bars of all different subdivisions that we can have between 1 and 8 notes. And that's really advanced because of the quintuplets and septuplets. Some drummers made it more popular recently, like Annie Canillas and Virgil Donati always used those subdivisions, but he has a deeper way of playing those subdivisions, so not everyone can really understand that he's playing that. But Annika really brought quintuplets to a way that we can understand it, and it's really cool. If you don't know Annie Canillas, you should check her out. Her songs are very cool, and she's a great drummer. But anyway, for this last example, you should know how to play quintuplets and septuplets. So if you don't know what those are and how to play those, you should definitely search for it and start studying it, because it's very cool to learn new subdivisions and to develop your time feel with those kinds of things. So now I'm gonna play the third example, 8 bars, going from quarter notes to 32nd notes, with every subdivision in between. And I'm gonna put my metronome a little bit slower. I'm gonna play this one at 70 beats per minute, because 32nd notes are way faster than 16th note triplets. And I want you to understand every note and every subdivision I'm playing. So I'm gonna play it at 70 BPM. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3. 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. And I don't use this idea only for my hands, I use it for my feet as well. So if you are a double bass drum player, or if you are a double pedal player, now I'm gonna show you those three examples played with my feet, with my double pedal, and I'll just keep time with my hands. I'll play quarter notes with my right hand on the hi-hat, and I'll play the snare on 2 and 4 just to keep time. Check it out. I hope you liked it. I use this exercise a lot to warm up my hands and my feet, and also to study and get better in those different subdivisions, those odd subdivisions. It's a great exercise to develop that. So I hope it's as useful for you as it is for me. Don't forget to subscribe to the YouTube channel, to follow on Instagram, to like the Facebook page. And if you want to receive every week a new drone lesson with transcriptions in your email, sign up to the mailing list at subscribe.dromosapiens.com. I see you next week.